Welcome to the club where BMX superstars are made.
You guys will be the best.
Home to some of the fastest adrenaline-fueled races in the UK. One season, one winner.
I'm the most prepared I can be for the race.
We're trackside as this lot fight to become world champions.
Are you guys excited?
In brand new BMX All-Stars.
We love that.
Watch now on CBBC and BBC iPlayer.
Join me later as I mark 150 years of the Salvation Army in Wales by celebrating the great work they do with communities here and across the UK.
Now on BBC One, the lunchtime news with Lakshmi Gopal.
World title last year. And tonight, the athletics continues, including the men's 100-metre final. Now, and just before we go, scientists say the world's biggest iceberg is stuck, spinning on the spot in the Southern Ocean. The iceberg, known as A23A, is more than twice the size of Greater London. It began drifting north 4 years ago and was expected to break up. But for the past few months, it's been caught in a vortex of water near the South Orkney Islands, which will delay its eventual demise. Well, sounds rather melancholy, doesn't it? Now, that is all from me for now, but there's plenty more on the BBC News website. The next news on BBC One is at 5 o'clock. Bye for now.
Hello there. Well, Sunday so far has been dominated by a quiet but rather cloudy start. Any glimpses of sunshine has been fleeting, but as you can see, a beautiful morning in Morgan, Cornwall. A glorious morning if you're a kite surfer in Northern Ireland, because the winds have been picking up here. We've got rain now and it will turn increasingly wet and windy as we go through the rest of the afternoon and into the evening. So here, some rain around, quite a lot of cloud. The cloud thick enough out to northwest England and Wales for the odd spot or two of drizzle. So the sunshine will tend to come and go in one or two spots if we're lucky. But those temperatures a little bit more subdued in comparison to the last few days. Highs of 23 degrees, 73 Fahrenheit. But the winds will continue to strengthen to the north and we'll see gusts in excess of 45 miles an hour. The rain turning quite heavy as it moves its way into western Scotland, all tied into this area of low pressure here. So we are going to start off on Monday on a north-south divide. But as this weather front pushes in, we're going to tap into a southwesterly wind. And we've got some extreme heat across the near continent at the moment. So it will turn increasingly humid. More on that in just a moment. But let's concentrate on this rain. The brighter yellows and greens denoting the intensity of the rainfall. We could see as much as 2 to 3 inches of rain falling across western Scotland. Perhaps lighter in nature through eastern Scotland. An intense but rather narrow band of rain to look out for in Northern Ireland first thing, and again rather cloudy skies across northwest England and Wales. But there will be some early morning sunshine to the east of the Pennines, and with that southerly flow, that humidity will increase as well. Now the rain will continue to move its way north and east, turning a little bit more fragmented in nature. Highs of 20 degrees here, but look at this, to the east of England we could see highs of 26 degrees once again. That's 80 Fahrenheit. Through the evening and overnight, that rain will continue to push its way southeast. A narrow band of intense heavy rainfall for a time, but because it's been so humid during the day, it could be quite an uncomfortable night for England and Wales to get a good night's sleep once again. As we move through Tuesday morning, though, some welcome news for gardeners out there across Lincolnshire, East Anglia and southeast England. Some much needed rain for our gardens. Behind it, slowly brightening up, but once again, a few scattered sharp showers being pushed into Northern Ireland and Scotland. Here only 19 or 20 degrees, but we could just see 25 in East Anglia. That's 77 Fahrenheit. Moving into Wednesday, low pressure returns once again into the far northwest and the winds will be a feature. So another spell of heavy rain here, not looking quite so bad across England and Wales. So it's a wet and windy day potentially into Scotland. Some showery rain out towards the west, but on the whole, a relatively dry day. Not quite as warm. We could see temperatures picking up at 23 degrees. Now, as we close out the rest of this week, that north-south divide is likely to continue. So we're always likely to see low pressure up into the far north of the country and weather fronts tumbling in. But the Azores High just sitting across the near continent. So from time to time, we are likely to see the best of the drier and the warmer weather across central and southern England. So we could see that heat and humidity returning into next week. But further north and west, it stays cooler with showers or longer spells of rain at times. Take care.
It's been an epic summer of sport, but it's not over yet. Four celebrities and their loved ones race from the Amazon to the Andes. No flights, no phones, no bank cards allowed. Who will cross the finish line victorious?
Well done, Fred. Let's get the pace up.
Every second counts.
Celebrity Race Across the World, Wednesday, 14th of August on BBC One and iPlayer.
That funny.
Oh, that's great. That's another good one.
Sitcom season, weeknights at 10 p.m. on BBC Two and iPlayer.
Salut from Salford. Christy with you live this Sunday afternoon on BBC One, where we're bringing the atmosphere from Paris to your front room.
Partly me thinks, am I taking too much on here?
They've come a long way, some of these lads, but I think there's so much potential still in there.
I want to take you on tour. I want to take you to India.
Wow!
I want them to see how big cricket is there, see what it means to people.
There's so much that being here has genuinely taught me.
Puts things into perspective a little bit for me. Representing England, but we're representing something far bigger than that. Representing Preston.
Freddie Flintoff's Field of Dreams starts Tuesday the 13th of August on BBC One and iPlayer.
You are in a lot of debt.
Mom, surprise!
I'm open for bookings.
As a joke, right?
You're a nomad, Mia. What kind of modelling job is this?
So many questions.
Spent. Watch on BBC iPlayer.
Now on BBC One, later than Build, the Tea Time News with Jane Hill.
More violence and rioting in English towns, including in Rotherham, where a hotel housing asylum seekers was stormed. Rioters also clashed with police in Bolton, Hull, Southport and Middlesbrough. Dozens of people have been arrested.
Windows smashed, police targeted and a building set alight. It's been a day of disturbing destruction here in Rotherham.
In the last hour, the Prime Minister has said he can guarantee the rioters will regret taking part in this disorder.
I utterly condemn the far-right thuggery we've seen this weekend.
And our other main story here tonight, there has been more success for Team GB at the Olympics. Lottie Fry took bronze in the dressage, which went right to the wire.
I'm live here at the Athletic Stadium in Paris ahead of a blockbuster night when two British sprinters will hope to line up in the final of the men's 100 metres.
Ireland. Ahead of it, though, it's going to be mostly dry, variable clouds, some spells of sunshine and very warm, up to 26 or 27 degrees here, but even the low 20s across Scotland. This weather front, though, will start to cross the country during Monday night. Could see some heavy thundery bursts on that as it pushes towards the east. On Tuesday, though, it will begin to fizzle out as it reaches east and southeastern areas, eventually pushing out into the North Sea. Skies brightening up behind it. Few showers, western Scotland, Northern Ireland, and it'll be feeling a little bit fresher again, 19 to 24 or 25 Celsius. And as we move through the rest of the week, most of the wind and rain will tend to be across more northern and western areas. Better chance of staying drier further south with sunshine and feeling quite warm at times. Take care.
Chefs, are you ready? Gladiators, are you ready?
What the hell is that?
Wish me luck.
Just trying to go with it.
TV's hottest cookery contest is back.
I serve everywhere.
Oh, it's burnt. Oh, my God.
Impressive job.
Absolutely fantastic.
This is what we call it, yeah!
The new series of Celebrity MasterChef starts Tuesday the 13th of August on BBC One and iPlayer.
Congratulations, Gemma. Is the father around?
Pass.
My life's a mess right now. This isn't something you should do on your own.
Dad, it's Gemma.
Glad you finally got to see the place.
Oh, what is that?
That's just where I've been crying.
Planning a birth is like planning a car crash.
Oh. Why can't you behave like a fully grown adult?
I'm going to be a granddad. These are happy tears.
Daddy Issues starts Thursday the 15th of August on BBC Three and iPlayer.
You might be winding down your Sunday evening, but there's no slowing us on BBC One. Anthony with you live here as Later Than Build, some of the world's fastest athletes, take their mark in Paris.